Simon Bloody Wilson.
My name is Simon Wilson, I'm 35 years old and I live in Albany on the North Shore of Auckland. I'm a sales manager for Konica Minolta. I manage their branch in Albany on the North Shore. I've got two sons, Finn who's 7 and Levi who's 5, and I have them every alternate week. I'm doing Fight Night because I had my last season of league this year and I sort of finished the season with a few injuries and was feeling a little bit disappointed about getting older and this sort of challenge presented itself. I've always liked watching boxing and always admired the fitness that the guys achieved to be able to do it, so I thought why not give it a go. Well, some of the highs would be, I suppose, working towards a goal with a group of guys that are like-minded and achieving a good level of fitness. The lows would be, I suppose, getting punched in the face from time to time. Also, I guess, not improving at the speed that you'd like to sometimes. I'd like to thank my coach Andrew Hepbury and Nate and Dee over at Takapuna Gym who've given up their time to train me. I'd also like to thank my sons for allowing me a bit of time to go and train.
So that's the journey of Simon Bloody Wilson, his opponent, a man who hails from the valleys, the boyos of Wales. He's come to God's own. He's been here now over 10 years. He is the Dr. David Bonehill.
My name's David Bonehill. I'm 35 years of age, originally from North Wales in the United Kingdom. I work for a company called K2 Consulting. We're an executive search company based in Tyne. We are headhunters. It's the best name for it, it's the old term name for it. So essentially we find hard to find people for businesses in and around Auckland and New Zealand. My family, my parents and my sister both live in the UK. My parents live in North Wales, my sister lives up in Leeds, and I'm the only one south of London. Why am I doing Fight Night? I'm doing Fight Night because I've been boxing for about 6 years for fitness purposes. I've known Mark Michaels now for about that same time. Mark asked me to get involved. I said yes, but I think it's a good idea to probably put what I've learned in the gym to use in the ring and just see how it all fits together. And I'd like to acknowledge first and foremost Glenside Boxing and my trainer Simon Rothwell. I'd like to thank Mark Michaels for the opportunity and for keeping on to me, for getting involved with this. Some of the thank yous really are to Jade and Brandon and Henry out of the gym for their time and patience with some sparring and training and their tips. And finally, just like to thank my friends for coming in on the evening to watch the fight. And a big thank you to my fiance Sam for all her support.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight, courtesy of Les Mills, please welcome to the ring, Simon Bloody Wilson. From the Blue Gates, the man who hails from Wales, Mr. Bonehill, David the Doctor.
What you seek is a wise man's treasure, you know.
This fight brought to you by Les Mills. All right, introducing the principals. First of all, from the red corner, he's 35 years of age. Weighed in at 92.4 kilos. Lost about 5 kilos for this fight. He plays rugby league, rugby union. He's a very active man. He has a BCom in public relations. The manager of Konica Minolta on Auckland's North Shore. And a former Black Caps media liaison officer. So if we ever wanted an interview with Richard Hadley or Shane Bond, this was the man. Please welcome Simon Bloody Wilson. His opponent is also 35 years of age. Weighs in at a slightly heavier 97 kgs. He is the director of K2 Consulting and Executive Search Company. It migrated from Wales back in 1998. They call him the Doctor. David Bonham. Your judges for this fight, Lorna Phillips, Andrew Bell, Greg Burgess. Our thanks once again to Les Mills, your referee, Lance Revel.
Well, here we go, Lance Revel calling together what looks like it could be one of our more closely contested bouts of the evening. Both guys very similar in size and stature. Age the same, 35 years. Simon Bloody Wilson, 92.4 kilos. Giving away about 4 kilos to David the Doctor Bonehill at 96. This is a heavyweight contest. Simon Wilson, a league player. Dave the Doctor Bonehill, an executive recruiter, but he looked pretty sharp in shadow boxing warming up. Both men finding their range with the jab. Slipping his head. Oh, there's the left hook, but keeping his composure well.
Looking forward to this one, Mike. Both 35, both similar weight, both very fit, very focused. There was some talk that this could possibly have been the main event, but it's the next one off the rank. And I tell you, both boys have got the eye of the tiger.
Yeah, both boys very focused. And they're interesting, Dave Bonehill, he actually looks very composed. He's moving his head quite well. He's trying, he's a little bit lazy on the jab, but he's picking his shots, trying different shots, trying different things, and not rushing in with his range. Although, he did, just as I said there, got clipped by a right hand from Simon Wilson. This isn't quite the rip-roaring brawls we've seen early on from the other fighters. Both fighters very measured. Little right overhand right over the top, answered with a left hook, straight right over the jab, again from Bonehill. Both guys just tending to rock back on their heels a little bit, expose their jaw. Just got to be careful if one or other of them doubles up on the jab and then follows with the right hand. Won't be good. This is one of the first fighters.
More technical fight, isn't it?
Yeah. It's also one of the first fights we've seen a left hook used regularly. Overhand right there, Simon Wilson. Both guys tying each other up. Not the frenetic action we've seen. Little jab there. Feigning the slip, then coming with an overhand right. Simon Wilson just slightly off balance as he throws his right hand. Missing with the right hand around the back, tying up on the inside. Little sneaky right hook as the break is called. Dave Bonehill just needs to be a little bit careful on the break. Doubles up on the jab nicely. Simon Wilson coming back. He knew he got clipped with a short right hand. Left hook in there just off the break. Once again, pretty even round from both boys.
Just a little tentative. Clearly both not expecting to come out this early after the what happened in fight five. So both caught a little bit off guard and perhaps just a little first round touchy-feely. But I'm expecting a lot more from these two in the next two rounds.
I think perhaps as they warm up, they might be a little bit cold, but I also think there's a fair deal of respect from both fighters for one another's power. There's some good eyes from both fighters. Both boys aren't just rushing in there. There's no rush of blood to the head. They're tying up nicely on the inside. They're not wasting punches, as you saw from some of the other fighters on the inside. Wasting punches, wasting energy. I think the fireworks will come perhaps in this round, but certainly in the third. Neither fighter breathing particularly hard in the corners as they've received their instructions. Fairly easy paced first round. No real shots thrown in anger.
be interesting to see how they respond once someone gets tagged the first time. Already a little bit more intensity. Simon Wilson's been told by his corner to come out and fire. Again, tied up on the inside by Bonehill. Answers with a nice lead right hand of his own. The old front headlock. Just hasn't quite got the timing on the 1-2, Simon Wilson. Nice doubling up with the jab to the body. Jab, then following up with a right hand to the body from Bonehill. Punching off the break. Both boys got a little bit of the sneaky shots where they punch off the break. Lance Revel will have told them, protect yourselves at all time in the ring. Little left hook, little digging right. Uppercut to the body there from Bonehill. Again, Simon Wilson tying him up.
I'm just surprised the lack of the intensity and work rate on this. Clearly, perhaps maybe they've got both of them just perhaps a little bit of stage fright. I don't know. They're both popping the jabs. There's a little bit of intent there, but there's a lot of holding as well. I don't think either have got them out of the first gear, to be honest.
I think what we're actually... Oh, there's a nice little right hand. What we're used to from some of these less experienced fighters is that they throw a lot more shots. It's a lot more frenetic. There's a little right hand. Off the break again from Simon Wilson. Plenty of wrestling there. It's not as exciting, but there's actually a little bit more thought going into this fight. Exchange of jabs. Both fighters connecting. A little bit of work to the body there from Dave the Dr. Bonehill. Left hook to the body. Little clipping right hand to the head. Simon Wilson tying up again. Lance Revel trying to encourage both guys to free their hands and start fighting on the inside. Yeah, there's a little... shot. How's your father? How's your mother?
Well, that's better from Simon Wilson. We're just not seeing the combos, are we? Just a lot of one punch.
Yeah. Just they just need to free their hands up a little bit more. Little right hand there. Doubling up again with the jab. Good work to the body there from Bonehill. And another little cheap shot on the inside. Simon Wilson can't really look to Lance Revel. He's thrown plenty of his own. Another pretty even round. Not many clean shots landed. If anyway, maybe David Bonehill scored a couple of shots towards the end of that round. May have caught the judges' attention. But really, not a lot to show for their efforts so far in rounds one and two.
Well, I suppose you look at the psychology of it at this point. I thought they were going to be fighting a lot later. Suddenly, you've gone from watch mode to fight mode after fight five was called off because of that injury. So you wonder just how much of a part this has taken in their mental preparation for this fight.
Well, it can certainly have an effect when your whole fight order has changed, particularly when you haven't been in the ring before. Interesting to note, both corners pretty calm talking to their men. Not a lot of G'ing up as you might expect, but certainly both of these fighters need to lift their intensity if they're going to take home the win at the end of this third and final round.
Mills come ringside for the presentations after the
third and final round.
Could Philip Mills and Norm Phillips come ringside for the presentation after this fight?
Crowd a little bit restless. They've seen a lot of action tonight, and already we've seen more action in this first 10 seconds of the third and final round than we have in the entire fight. We've gone back to that familiar grappling position. Oh, Lance Revel just calling the shot on the break. Confusion from both fighters as they continue. Probably both came off all right there. Little left hand caught him on the way in. Bit of leak from the league player, Simon Bloody Wilson. Needs to give himself some room. Looking at his corner, shaking his head at this point. Lance Revel not giving him any time to breathe, straightening up the headgear, and away we go again. Little right hand, that one clipped off the shoulder. Not really getting his arms free. There's a little right hand. Windmill shots there from Simon Bloody Wilson, driving his man back with his shoulder, trying to get his arms free. David Bonehill getting caught by another right hand. Bonehill's more of the technical fight. Nice overhand right, going downstairs to the body. Be good if he could free up his left hand and go to the head. He tries. But Simon Wilson walking forward, not giving him the punching room. Nice little lead right hand again.
Now they're starting to heat up.
Well, it's still a bit of a wrestling match in there, but at least they're firing shots. Simon Wilson, he's walking forward. He's not allowing his man, who's probably got the more skilled punching arsenal, to tee off on him. Nice little jab. Timing
lovely
on
jab,
the way
lovely
in.
Jab
oh, that one might have just got his attention. Nice little digging body shot there from Bonehill. He's doing what he can when his hands are free. Little uppercut on the inside. Wilson going with another body shot of his own. Now Bonehill. Nice little right hand again.
Well, that was one of the best punches.
To turn the tide of the fight. When he's got range, when he's throwing a shot, He's actually looked the more technical of the two fighters. He just needs to free his arms. He needs to do a lot more work. Keep on twisting and turning. And again, turning away there, firing a right hand on the break. Oh, nice. Doubling up. Right hand to the body. Tyson-esque. Right hand to the body, right hand to the head. That familiar overhand right over the jab. Well, David the Doctor Bonehill probably took that third and final round. Not a lot in the first two. Wasn't enough to take the fight on the judges' cards.
All right, let's get a few words from our contenders. First of all, Simon Bloody Wilson. I suppose a bit of a shock to the system. You're expecting Fight 5 to go a lot longer, then suddenly you get the call, you're on, boys. But how did that feel?
It felt like I could have done with another 6 months training, but Dave's got a bit more skill and experience than me. But I think I gave him a good matchup, and certainly I've enjoyed the process of getting how to throw a punch and move. It's great to have some friends here. It's a great event, and anyone who's considering doing it, I highly recommend it, because it's fast track and fitness is made out about it. So thank you.
Who would you like to thank, Simon?
Well, just the obvious people, my trainer, Andrew Paulo, and people associated with him. Obviously my family, because it is a big commitment. That's about it. Just thanks for coming along tonight. It's good fun. Cheers.
Awesome. Simon Bloody Wilson. All right, let's talk to the man from Wales. David, same question to you. This fight happened a bit earlier than expected. Fight 5 been called off so quickly, then suddenly you're told you're on. So how did this one feel for you?
I was lying down my iPod about 5 minutes before, so.
Said he was lying down with his iPod 5 minutes before he knew he was on, so you're obviously very relaxed. But who would you like to thank?
Mark Michael's the one putting this thing together. All my friends and supporters over there. Simon Ruffo, my trainer, great boxing mind. Brandon, thanks, buddy. Simon, good fight, I mean, you know.
Now, the All Blacks take on Wales tomorrow morning in Cardiff. Wales hasn't beaten the AB since 1953. It's been 55 long years. Is anything going to change tomorrow morning?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, 10-0 drift easy.
All right, thank you very much. David Bonehill, ladies and gentlemen. And if we could please welcome to the ring Norm Phillips and Philip Mills. This fight obviously sponsored by Les Mills. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision in favour of the blue corner. David Bonehill. And we'll just take this opportunity to get a few words from Philip Mills, of course. Les Mills, the sponsor of this fight.
Hey, thanks everybody for coming along tonight. What a great night, eh? Isn't this fun? I'd like to congratulate all the fighters for just a fantastic job, some amazing stories. The guys that have lost 10 kilos, 20 kilos, it's wonderful to hear about that. So a big round of applause for all the fighters tonight, please. And my old Commonwealth Games teammate, Lance Revel, wonderful refereeing job, mate. Great to see you again. And everybody, just like a big round of applause for Mark Michaels and all of his team for organising such a fantastic event.
Thank you very much, Philip. And thanks to Les Mills, all your support. Without you, this would not have been possible. All right, now, a lot of talk about whether or not Robert the Bruce is going to get a new opponent. If I just call into the ring, referee Dave Renata. Ringside Doctor Dave Renata. Dave, first of all, what did you think of the quality of the fights tonight?
Pretty good so far, yeah. I've been quite a few tournaments and they've been well matched.
Well, you're widely regarded as one of the best, if not the best, ringside doctors, so we're very lucky to have you. Now, Mike Burke. We all know Mike can fight. He's been the main event twice. Can you confirm whether he's fighting or not tonight against Robert the Bruce?
He won't be fighting. No, he's had too much alcohol, so end of story.
Thank you very much, Dave. We really appreciate it. You obviously had to make a difficult decision, but that's the way boxing is.
Yeah, he made it easy for me.
He made it easy for you. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. We all know that Mike Burke can fight, but in the name of safety tonight, he's not, because he's had a few too many drinks. All right, which brings us now to our main event.